If you're a longtime Kontakt user like I am, you may have accumulated a ton of sample libraries. I haven't done a recent count myself, but I'm definitely into the terabytes by now. I have a humongous and eclectic sample library collection. Some of them are player libraries that show up in the Libraries tab. Others are commercial libraries which are not encoded as player instruments, and then random downloads from this or that website, and a lot of instruments I've just made myself over the years. There's a huge challenge in keeping my Kontakt sample library organized. This isn't just something for neat freaks, it actually drastically impacts my creativity and my workflow. Let's put it this way, when I'm in the midst of composing, if I can't quickly reach out for the thing that I need and start using it, if I'm constantly spending time rifling through folders and drives and subfolders looking for something specific, then I get distracted from the creative process. It's kind of like a builder having to run out to the hardware store every time they need a new tool. I've made a couple of videos on this topic before describing different ways that I've used to organize my Kontakt sample library. And for various reasons, I've now migrated to a new system, which I'd like to show you in this video. So let's scratch all that, I'm going to show you my new system for organizing my Kontakt libraries. Before we get there, let's review the different ways that you can currently load files into Kontakt. Method number one would be the Libraries tab, which you can see here in my left sidebar. The Libraries tab works reasonably well. You open up a library and you load a patch. Its weakness is that you can only put Kontakt player libraries in here. And while there's a huge selection of Kontakt player libraries, there's an even bigger collection out there of commercial and independent non-player libraries that can't go into the Libraries tab. So let's look at method number two, the Files tab. This works okay, but it does require a lot of clicking. For example, I'm going into my Samples 3 drive, into my Kontakt Samples 1 folder, and I might double-click on a library folder, into the Instruments folder, into a Patch folder, and then I might find the patch that I want to load. This is organizationally clear, but it's not sorted the way I actually need it to be sorted when I'm working. When I'm working, I might think to myself, I need to load violas, but violas might be scattered amongst different folders, different libraries, different drives. So I need a way to see all my violas at once, and the Files tab does not give me that. A third way to load patches is using the database. I actually really do love using the database when I need to do a keyword search. Once you've used the database options to index and scan your entire sample library collection, even if it spans multiple folders and multiple drives, Kontakt is now smart enough to search for patches and folders that match your search criteria. For example, let's just say I want to load a Guiro, but I want the East-West one. Well, I can just type the folder name, which is EWQLSO for me, and then Guiro, and Kontakt's database is smart enough to find folders and file names that match my criteria. And there are my three Guiro patches ready to load. But the database can also be its own worst enemy. If I were to do a database search for viola, I will find literally hundreds of viola patches, and they're a little bit messy. Some are obvious what they belong to, others are not. And it's hard for me to know what I'm loading or what library I'm working with. Kontakt offers yet a fourth way to load patches, and that is by using Quick Load. Drag any patches you want right into Quick Load, and they'll be there, kind of like favorites. You can even right-click, add a new folder, and then move your patches into them and organize them that way. This is not a bad system, but for me, it consumes a lot of Kontakt real estate, and it takes a long time to set up. So let's scratch all that, and I'm going to show you my new system for organizing my Kontakt patches and libraries. I'll start with the end result. This is what it looks like when it's finished. This is a special collection of smart folders in the macOS Finder. Side note, if you like my system of organization, I will put this list of folders in the video description below so you can copy it for yourself. The beauty of the system is when I click on any smart folder, I can use macOS's column view to instantly see every library and every patch that I've chosen to put in that folder. When I find a patch I like, I can just drag it straight into Kontakt. It's very quick and versatile, and I'm constantly adding to it and re-tagging new libraries that I acquire. So let's dive in, and I'll give you the tutorial on how I set this up. The first thing I need to do is go to my Finder Preferences and look on the Tags page. Tags can be used for many things around macOS, so I've chosen to name all of my Kontakt library tags with a K and a hyphen before them. So for the purposes of this video, let's just add a new one, and I'll call it K-NewCategory. You can have it show up in your macOS sidebar. I don't prefer to do that, but that's personal taste, because my Finder windows would have to be massive to accommodate all of my Kontakt tags in the sidebar. So now let's start going through my actual Kontakt library. For me, this is spread across multiple drives, so I have hundreds of folders ahead of me to organize. Let's take this folder, Apollo Cinematic Guitars. I would like to tag this folder so that it can be organized in my smart folders, but I don't actually want to move the location of the library. If I did, any projects that I had used it on in the past would then complain about missing samples, and that makes my composing a little more complicated. So I do my best not to move Kontakt libraries after they've found their home. So with Apollo Cinematic Guitars, let's right-click on it, and I'll choose Tags. A pop-up menu comes up, and if I click Show All, I can see all of my tags. Obviously, this is a guitar library, but it also has a lot of ambient textures in it, so I'd like to add it to ambient textures as well. And let's just say it's one of my favorites. I also have a tag called Miscellaneous Faves. Quick side note, speaking from experience, I use my Miscellaneous Faves folder a lot. So I don't hesitate to put patches or libraries that I really like into the Misc Faves tag. When I'm done, I can hit return and those tags get applied to that folder. You can apply tags to folders or subfolders or individual patches. It's totally up to you. Here's a collection of 4 random drum patches. So here, let me call up tags, show all, and I'll put them in the acoustic drums category. I'll also put them in SSG. That's my personal tag for style-specific genres, because I can tell from the names of those patches that they are really specific as to the genre and the style they come from. Let me take one more example. Take a look at Omega Drums here. I could right-click on Omega Drums and give that my drums tag, but once I drill into its folder, I find it really only has 1 NKI. So why not tag this? That way I save myself the trouble of constantly having to go into Omega Drums, into Instruments, and then to the actual patch. One other side note, cataloging my library like this has been a really nice journey of discovery. I don't remember off the top of my head what Omega Drums are. Are they acoustic? Are they electronic? Are they big and epic? I've set myself a personal goal of getting through my entire Kontakt library about 20 or 30 folders per day. And if a patch or a library comes up like this that I'm not sure what it was, I go ahead and load it so that I can reacquaint myself with what I have. And in doing this, I've rediscovered literally hundreds of things in my library that I had forgotten about and that I might want to make use of in future composing. There are a few advanced ways to automate the adding of tags to Finder files and folders. I'm not going to get into them in this video. I'll leave a link down below to an article that explains some of these. Let's go back to my master organizational set of smart folders now. If I click on the guitars folder, I can see that Apollo Cinematic Guitars is right here. And if I want to open it up and go inside its instruments folder, I can find one of its patches and I can load it instantly by just dragging it right into Kontakt. But moving back in the hierarchy, that can also be found if I go to Ambient Pads Rhythmic. It's also here. And if I were to go to my Misc Faves folder, it's also here. So if you catch my drift, it's really easy to put the same patch or same library into multiple folders so that you can find it when you're looking for it. And that really gets to the most important point that I want to drive home in this video. When I'm composing, I don't want to spend a ton of time hunting and pecking through folders and subfolders and drives. When I'm in my creative flow, I think to myself, I need to add a guitar here, and I really want to be able to see all of my guitar options at once, so I can audition them and then choose the one that best fits the sound that I'm going for in this project. So by using this system, I can quickly jump to every type of instrument I need. A couple more things to show you. Remember, I created this new category. Let's create a smart folder for that. I'm next going to show you how to set up all of these smart folders so they can be used in this way. This is done in the Finder in the File menu. Just choose New Smart Folder and tell it to search the entire Mac, then hit the plus button to set up some search criteria, and we're going to choose Other, then search for Tags, and add Tags, and we'll say Matches, and we'll manually type K-New Category. No files appear because we haven't put anything into that category just yet. But now I'll hit save so I can save this smart folder. And I'm going to navigate to the place where all of my smart folders are kept. I chose one location on my hard drive, which I called Kontakt Library Categories. And let's go ahead and give this folder a name, New Category. You also have the option of adding it to your sidebar. Again, I don't do this personally because I don't want my sidebar to get out of control, but you may like it. I'll go ahead and click save. And now when I go into Kontakt Library Categories, there is my new category. And just to test that it works, let's take this folder just at random and we'll give it the category, New Category, hit return, and then come back to my smart folder called New Category, and there it is. You can repeat this process for every category that you decide to define and for every library or patch that you decide to put into that category. One other advanced tip that I'd like to share with you. If you follow my channel, then you know that I'm a huge fan of Keyboard Maestro, which is the premier automation utility for the Mac. I've written a Keyboard Maestro macro here that no matter where I am on my computer, anytime I hit F5, this macro will activate the Finder, open a new window that displays all my smart folders, the Kontakt Library Categories, resize that folder window, place it in the exact location I like on my screen, and then execute a quick Apple script to make sure that it's in column view. I'll leave a copy of this Apple script in the description below if you'd like to use it. So here it is in action. As soon as I press F5, instantly, there's my folder. And if Kontakt is open in my DAW, I can find the patch I like and instantly load it. And there you go. I hope these videos have been helpful to you. Please do like and subscribe. On my channel, you'll find a ton of composer and context-centric content. I hope these techniques help you spend more time flowing in the creative process and less time wasted going through your virtual filing cabinets. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one.